So let's walk through the steps of the scientific method. Step one, make an observation. Go out and pay attention to something. Step two, create a hypothesis. A hypothesis is an educated guess based on previous experience or knowledge. And there's a couple key parts to that definition. So, educated guess. It has to be something based on prior knowledge. It can't be just a wild guess with no basis in any kind of background or fact. So, why are pallid bats in oak woodlands? Because the aliens put them there. That's maybe not an educated guess. That's a guess. Based on previous experience or knowledge, this is where someone who's been studying a particular organism or a particular body system is going to make a more educated guess than someone with a less background. And you just build on that and you get better and better at developing hypotheses. So, a couple characteristics of a good scientific hypothesis. They need to be specific. You need to be able to collect data to answer a specific question. And if your question or your hypothesis is too broad, it's going to be difficult to test that hypothesis. And it also needs to be testable. So, pallid bats are there because of aliens. There's not really an easy test I'm going to be able to run for that. And so, that's not a good scientific hypothesis. I want to step back quickly and talk about the goals and uses of science. The goal of science is to better explain and understand the natural world. So, when you, even physics and chemistry, along with biology, the whole idea here is what's happening and how can we explain it in a reasonable, data-based way? And the use of science is to help solve problems. How can we make people healthier? How can we reduce air pollution in the water and the air? These are the kinds of things where we're trying to understand the natural world, understand what's happening, and use that to solve problems. And really, that is the goal and use of science.